I got to talk. I got to tell what I feel. I got to talk about my life as I see it.
Welcome to With Apologies, everybody.
Nobody gives a shit about that. Al-Qaeda just came out against them. You gotta be pretty bad for Al-Qaeda to be like, yeah, we're out.
You guys pick on me and I want you to be my friend.
Poor me, I need attention.
You can say close? Welcome to Canada!
You know, we don't get the pleasure of
you
it going up
hit,
the ass,
I mean,
unfortunately.
It's not terrible.
No,
if you saw it for free, you'd be happy. If you paid $7, you might be a little pissed.
It's like I need some fucking Novocaine. There's so much nerve to it.
I'm scared every time a girl goes, I wish you would let me go because my family cares about me and I've been missing for 5 days.
By current definition, I've raped a lot of girls.
Yes, all men are genetically designed to want to rape you.
I thought enough of your Black History horseshit, okay? Forget it, you're black.
I shit myself last week, I shit myself all the time.
With Apologies is live every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Eastern on Spreaker.com. Check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and iTunes.
And I have one thing to say to that. Crayons are yummy.
Jerry, have you done anything where you're trying to get an applause from the crowd?
Every now and then, yeah. It's usually when I'm ripping on hockey teams, though.
Well, that's not that bad, I guess.
See, now, that's not that bad as... like the guy that goes, you know, all these people complaining about healthcare, like,
yeah.
you know.
We need to do something about this, everybody.
Yeah, like,
woo!
I don't like that, where those
yeah.
dudes have, I fucking hate that shit. That's why I say, Jerry, no matter what happens in his career, so, like, say if Jerry has, like, the Bill Cosby shit end up happening to him. He is automatically above all those fucking shitty comics. Jerry's better than Brian Stern. There you go.
I mean, we have to talk about that. We'll talk about that with Ian, because Ian's going to have something to say about that.
Anyway,
all know that.
Jerry.
Jerry.
Yeah.
I am very yeah. upset with you right now, sir.
What I do?
Lots of things.
Is it because I'm cheering for St. Louis?
No!
Because I'm...
What, yeah, actually,
okay.
yeah, it's the fact
well,
that
yeah.
you said, and I quote, could you bring it up,
Let's
Nick?
Bring up the quote. I thought you'd memorize the quote, because you hated that
Okay,
much.
Let me read what you said.
Yeah.
Because I'm telling you, I think this is blasphemous. Dear St. Louis Rams.
This is the quote.
If you want to prove anything, sorry, okay, maybe you read it.
Okay, Dear St. Louis Rams, if you want to prove you're anything but a joke, you'll beat Seattle and give Dallas a first road bye.
Round.
Or whatever the fuck it is. Sincerely, Mr. Jerry Farr.
Jerry, what the fuck do you mean by that? Because if you're talking shit saying, the way I looked at it, I'll just say the way I read that, was that you think St. Louis is a joke unless they beat Seattle.
Well, that could play the spoiler. I mean, if you want to look at it technically, the way that goes is Dallas has already won the division, and they're number three.
Yeah.
And in the NFL, in order to get the first round bye, you got to be number one or number two. Now, the two teams ahead of Dallas right now is Seattle and Detroit.
Yeah.
Okay? Now, Detroit is playing Green Bay, and both teams are already in the playoffs, so the winner of that game will get a first round bye.
Yeah.
And... so it'll either be Detroit or Green Bay getting a first-round bye. The only way that Dallas is going to get it is if St. Louis can come back and beat Seattle. Because when I posted that, it was tied at 6. And then right after I posted that, Seattle scored two touchdowns.
So, yeah, and you're a Cowboys fan, right?
I've been a Cowboys fan since I was a kid.
All right.
Aikman, Emmitt Smith, Michael Irvin, those guys, that was my team.
Okay.
Well, that is my team.
But
you know what I mean? That is my team.
But
yeah.
you're not. So you are not saying St. Louis is a joke right now.
St. Louis is a joke right now.
Ooh. How? When okay. They... okay. Ooh. Wait. Wait.
Yeah.
Wait. How can you say that when the NFC South has been the worst division I have ever seen in my fucking life right now. How dare you fucking say that? How dare you say that?
You got me there. You got me there. I actually had a conversation with myself inside my head. The voice inside my head saying, "Hey, Jerry, are you watching the St. Louis Rams play?" I said out loud, "No, I'm watching the St. Louis Rams try." They try, and they gave up 14 points.
Jerry's always trying to be profound.
Jerry, this is what, Jerry, I'm going to help you when I think you calm me here, okay? Just, you don't have to try and be profound. Just tell a joke about the Rams. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Like, talk about maybe how, I don't know, James Laurinaitis, his ball bag stinks or something. Just something like that. Jerry.
John Laurinaitis. Oh, my gosh. I'm going to start with you.
I don't know. Look, there's not many Ram jokes. So you talk about how they're getting rammed in the ass by, you know, a Seahawk. Talk about how funny that would look. This is what I'm saying, Jerry, is the Seahawks or the Rams aren't a bad fucking team. They don't have a quarterback.
Okay, you got me there. You got me there.
Jerry, look at... No. Okay, and I'm going to prove it. Go to the Rams schedule. Look who they've beaten, okay? They beat the 49ers. They beat the Broncos. They lost by 3 to the Chargers. They lost by 6 to the Cardinals. And they hung in tough with the Eagles. They're a team that if they were in a different division, if they were in the NFC South, come on, man. Look, my whole thing, Jerry, is simply this. How can you fucking say that shit when the NFC South is as bad as I've ever seen four fucking teams be?
Can I answer that for him? Because Jerry needs to have something to say.
You know what? I take that back because I did see that they shut out 2 straight teams. They beat out Oakland 52-0, and then they beat out Washington 24-0.
Or didn't they lose to the Redskins?
No, they beat the Redskins in week 14.
Oh, sorry, they did beat the Redskins. You're right. Sorry. And I know those aren't 2 great teams, but hey, shutting 2 teams out is still a big deal. But I'm just saying, like, I was explaining it like this. Like, you're talking about, like, a car accident that happened on 9/11. Like, oh my God, yeah, there was a car accident. And I'm like, okay, but 2 fucking buildings just came down. And you're like, but this car accident was really bad. Okay,
hey,
but 4,000
people
died.
I haven't seen Dallas come this close to the playoffs or any close to the Super Bowl since they last won it.
Who didn't?
So some people are trying to say, there's a girl at work that says that the Dallas Cowboys are kind of like the Toronto Maple Leafs of football. That's not necessarily true.
They absolutely... Wait. Whoa. How the fuck can you say it? They absolutely are. They haven't been good in years. Well, that's not a correct thing, okay? They choke. Tony Romo chokes. He's a choke artist. That's what he does.
Exactly.
Tony Romo gets waterboarded every time he steps on the field, okay? Now, and then they play in the fucking billion-dollar, like, world dome. The thing that looks like a spaceship Cowboy Stadium, or whatever the fuck they call it now. And they choke all the time.
Holy shit, that sounds exactly like the fucking Leafs. They got an amazing stadium. They got a lot of expensive shit.
Everyone pays attention to them every time.
Everybody
wants
the jersey and the fucking sweatshirt and the helmet or whatever.
Everyone wants to play for them because
they
get exposure. Remember that? Remember Terrell Owens with his whole trying to kill himself shit? When he started crying, going, "That's Tony Romo, that's my quarterback. Don't you make fun of him." Even though he talked shit on Donovan McNabb like years before that, and he called Jeff Garcia a faggot. That's what I'm saying. The fucking Cowboys are the Leafs. How can you... Jerry, that girl is right.
Toronto should just buy them.
Come on, man.
Yeah. The Texas Leafs.
It would be funnier if they couldn't spell... If they spell Cowboys wrong. Because the Leafs are the only team in the NHL whose nickname is spelled grammatically incorrect. Because it's supposed to be L-E-A-F-S. But it's L-E-A-F-S.
Yeah, but
that's fucked up.
Jerry, I think we do need a better spell check.
Exactly. Thank you, Jerry. Let's introduce Ian Ellis to the
conversation. Wait. Yeah, that's the point. They can afford a better stadium. They can't afford spell check for their team. No.
All right. Well, how about this? They can't afford the right color for the Leafs.
Not hitting women and spelling words correctly.
They can't afford the right color for a fucking maple leaf. It's blue and white.
Jesus Christ.
Maple leaves are green or red.
Jerry, like,
who fucking made that design? Helen Keller?
Stevie Wonder did. He spilled the paint over.
Who sits there looking at this, like, the spelling and just, you know, watch a different
Listen,
team or
I can't shit on Jerry for that because it is kind of hard to come up with a Maple Leaf improv about other than just ripping on the team to rip something up.
I'll agree with that.
Could just say, oh, Stevie Wonder. I'm not going to explain that. Because when you explain the joke, there is no joke. Yeah. I don't know. I just talked a while ago.
Oh, Jerry. I'm just saying, Jerry, like, I can't even believe the fucking nerve of you to post that when fucking the NFC South has been so bad. Has been so bad that, like, I've never seen a fucking cavalcade of shit like I've seen with the NFC South this year.
Those teams have been taking a bigger hit than Rihanna.
Jerry, spell cavalcade.
Cavalcade?
Spell cavalcade.
C-A-V-A-L-C-A-D-E.
C-A-V?
Is that right?
Yep.
Cavalcade?
Yeah. Is that how you say
C-A-V-A-L-C-A-D-E.
It spelled?
C-A-V-A-L-C-A-D-E.
Isn't that right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, he's right.
Yeah, Nick, you're a fucking... Nick, see... This is what
I'm just
exhausted
for Jerry.
You
today.
Know what? You know what?
I'm
Nick,
way too tired.
You cannot talk shit about Jerry's Maple Leaf thing because you fucking thought that Islington Station
Islington.
In Toronto was Islington.
That's the way it should be said.
Like you.
You know that's the way it should be said.
You
put an L after an S. It's an isle.
No, it's not. So is an isle?
Yes.
Yep, I'm definitely watching the Rams try. You know,
I'm
within the last 20 seconds, they were at one point at 2nd and 32.
Jesus. Okay, that's bad.
So,
wow.
All right, maybe
yeah.
He's got a point.
The
this
thing
whole
is, I'm
going to
give it to
thing.
Them. I'm going to give it to Seattle. You know, they have the best defense. They proved it in the Super Bowl. I even said, defense. They've got the defense. They're going to take it.
All right, there's Jerry's wacky sports for you.
Hey, don't listen. Jerry, I just think you should maybe say that if St. Louis is a joke, then
yeah.
The NFC like South is like a Richard Pryor album. Okay, like it's jokes. It's tons of jokes. Come on, man.
Jerry, who do you have in the WNFL?
What was that?
Who do you have in the WNFL?
And which one are you listening to music in the
Said
fucking
the
background?
WNFL.
The WNFL. There's a WNFL?
Yes, the WNFL.
Well, it's like the lingerie league.
Are you saying you don't believe in women?
I'm saying I believe in women.
Can you turn off the
fucking
country music?
You just don't like them or find them attractive. That's what you're saying.
Ian, could you turn the fucking country music
off? You are like a woman. You're putting words in my mouth. Fuck. That's why I stay single as long as I can.
Jared, it's called a joke.
Because I don't want to... Because I'm tired of that. I hate it when people put words in my mouth.
Are you going to cry?
Yes, I'm going to cry all the way to the bank.
Sounded like you were crying.
Oh, man. You know
yes, what? I'm crying. Oh, boo. I'm crying so hard.
You got to isolate that so I can have it as a cell phone.
Definitely.
Fuck it. I think Jerry and Brian Stern would be a great show.
Absolutely. The retard show.
No, just because I think... That, I don't know. I just want to see it.
You don't want to say what you're thinking about Jerry right now.
Go
no,
ahead.
I don't. I just,
heard...
I'm upset that Jerry would talk the shit that he would.
Jerry talks shit about everything. Don't you have him on Facebook?
I do have him on Facebook.
He talks shit about shit he shouldn't, he has no business talking shit about. He just needs to say shit.
Yeah, but like, you know, come on, man. Jerry, here was my only problem with what you did though, right? Was how I brought up points of why you shouldn't talk shit about the Rams.
He just agreed.
And then you agreed. Which means you didn't, you weren't even like you weren't even attached to how you felt about the Rams.
You just, that's
I
what
am
I'm
not,
saying.
I'm sorry, I'm not passionate right now.
Where you brought up spelling, but you know you can't read.
Like, Jerry
okay.
Fucking, Jerry, like, you know why Jerry's like this right now today? Jerry's like this because, you know, the Cowboys actually made the fucking playoffs. So maybe he's, like, so... He's not with it today because he's just, like, kind of in a happy mood. Like, he's not going to be pissed off no matter what happens. You know?
What the fuck was that? Did you hear that?
I've...
So Someone just got in, like, a car accident.
Yeah, I think Ian just died.
Yeah, he just went through the windshield.
Oh.
No, but
I'm
Jerry,
getting another beer.
Jerry, you say things that are just empty. Like, they just, they don't matter. No, nobody cares.
Well, he didn't, oh, not about, he didn't say that about the Rams.
Well, the Rams thing got something out of you. But, like.
Because it was, that's an egregious mistake. That's, like, posting that and not saying anything about the NFC South.
Okay, so if there's not, like, a bunch of
bullshit coming out of
his fucking.
I don't need to say anything about the NFC South.
Why the fuck not?
It speaks for itself at the moment.
Yeah, but
I mean,
the
winner's going to be the one with 7 wins. I mean, isn't the first time that it's happened.
That's the second time ever, and the fact that the Rams have 6 wins, and they're only going to, but they played a lot of tough teams, and the fact that if they played in the NFC South, they'd probably have 12 wins? Come on, man.
So is the point that he just spews shit about one thing, like he's a professional analyst, and then just doesn't give a shit about anything else that's going on?
Maybe, I don't know. Maybe Maybe the fact that he needs St. Louis to win so his team can get a bye.
First round bye.
Yeah.
That's all I was trying to say because,
well, then,
St. Louis, like, one time they won the Super Bowl, they had the easiest schedule in the world. I was expecting them to lose that year. I was like, yeah, this is just a one-time thing. They're not going to do it. And then they did it. I'm like, okay, they got their title.
Are you talking about like the Kurt Warner era, like 10 years ago?
Jerry's like 50 years old.
Jerry, how old are you?
I hit 31 last month.
Ooh.
Okay, so he probably is talking about like 10 years. Jerry, you're talking about like when I was playing Madden on fucking Xbox, man. Come on, man. I don't know, man. Jerry, you just that post kind of rubbed me the wrong way.
Jerry, your posts are. This is something I've been meaning to talk about. Your posts are just fucking aggravating. Like, I don't know why I still have you on Facebook. It's just everything you say is just like, I just, why? Why are you saying things that don't matter? Nobody cares.
Not what I mean. I felt like, Jerry, like, why would you say this?
It's
about the Rams, though.
Well, why does he say it? That's what I'm saying. You go through, you're like, why are you saying this? I don't care. Nobody cares.
Jerry, like, you know what Jerry needs to do? Is I think Jerry, Jerry's got to, like, he's got to go on the road. That's what I think. Jerry, where's your next show at? Where's your next show at?
I haven't decided that. I'm waiting until I hear something from one of the bookers. Because I don't know if you saw that post on Facebook last month, but I told the city of Halifax, I'm done. I'm done with producing shows in Halifax.
Whoa, okay, no.
I'm trying to find that post, Jerry, but I got to sift through all the fucking game invites and all the fucking, hey, Jerry just won the past night of the show on Quiz Tower.
Yeah, here's it. See, okay, now, Jerry, see, Nick's trying to be bad cop, and I'm not trying to be good cop, because I'm generally trying to help you, because here's the thing.
I'm not.
Like, what you just said, right? That's like... That's a big thing right there. But we're stuck with fucking game invites, man.
Right.
I don't check Facebook enough to fucking see that shit. But, like, I'd want to fucking hear that.
Right. That, Jerry, if you never posted anything or rarely, you know, just things about comedy, and then that thing came up, I'd be like, oh, shit, Jerry's saying something for real here.
Yeah, Jerry, like, that's an actual thing.
I'd read that, and I'd comment
that
on
matters.
It.
That matters.
I don't comment on anything, and I would comment on that. I'd say something.
All right, so you know what, Jerry? What's going on?
Yeah,
man? Come
explain.
Explain.
Are you okay, sweetie?
No, Ian, Jerry just, like, dropped a bomb on us, and it was like, we gotta, like, hear what's going on.
Yeah, let me just sift through more game invites.
Let me give you a
quick thing.
And now Seattle won. And Dallas is not getting a first-round bye.
Good.
All right.
Fuck the Cowboys.
Thank you very much. Please cock the gun and pull the trigger.
Fuck them up their fucking asses. Yeah, they did get fucked by a bunch of seagulls.
I just got kicked off of Skype for trying to sign in on 2 devices. And now I'm calling from my phone. So, Jerry, tell us how long you've been gay. What emotional issue was he crying about?
Up until the point I first heard of you. So right now I'm back to being straight. So
whoa!
No, fucking Jerry.
Watch out, Rose Battle.
Jerry is not producing shows anymore in
Halifax. I'm done with it.
In his city.
Okay. Let me explain what happened here.
Wait, Jerry,
I've been trying to produce shows because through October, well,
let's be honest,
through the summer, I had
really
a new room. Yeah, I had a new room over in Halifax, right, at this place called The Lower Deck. So I tried that for every couple weeks, right? Mm-hmm. We barely got a crowd, and I was trying to do this thing that I used to do at my old show over at another bar called Gus's Pub.
Where you guessed the blowjobs. It was really successful.
Yeah, it was. And I heard you have a very tiny penis, so I'd have nothing to worry about with you. So with Gus's, what I used to do was one show every month. We took the door money and we donated it to a charity of some sort, whether it was, you know.
So this is comedy for charity. Society.
Yeah. Right. It was a charity show. We had the
Scientology or Fight the Gay or ISIS. They would donate money to charities.
Yes, we used to donate to them.
All right, so Jerry's trying to raise money for ISIS. Good.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Yes.
That's established.
That's exactly. I'm saying this in the most sarcastic tone I can think of. Yes, that is exactly what
I would
do. Why
don't you say it in the funniest tone you can think of?
Yeah, because that sounded like a robot.
Jesus.
Well, if I could do your voice exactly, you know, I don't know. I'm just saying it. Let me finish.
Oh my God.
What we did was
that's
one
what your mom said
show
last
every
night.
Month.
Oh my God.
You what?
Okay, Ian, like. How about we do this, Ian?
This is just fucking exhausting. Yes.
Just let Jerry tell his story, please, and don't save the jokes until he's finished, because I want to hear this, please.
Okay.
Go ahead, Jerry. Go ahead.
And Nick, you shut the fuck up, too.
Okay. So one show every month at Gus's Pub, we took the door money and donated to a charity, whether it was, you know, my... any type of charity, you know, Canadian Cancer Society,
all right, Jerry,
Red Cross, anything like that.
We get that part.
Yeah. So I tried that with Lower Deck, and we barely got anyone in the door. So one day, the owner of the bar called and said, yeah, we got to cancel the show. There's no one coming. So we did actually two shows for charity. The first show we did was actually in memoriam of Robin Williams. Because the week before we did that show, he passed away.
Get to the fucking point!
No, we barely got any donations.
I don't even know where we started. What are we talking about anymore?
I'm talking about why I'm not doing shows anymore.
Jerry, you said you're giving up on Halifax.
Yeah.
Is it because no one came to your shows?
It's because, pretty much, yeah. I mean, if I'm putting out shows, you know, no one's showing up. Other comics, they're getting a whole bunch of people out there.
Now, is it just you on these shows? Who else on these shows?
I can get almost any comedian in Halifax to do a charity show.
Nice.
So basically, other comedians get people to come out because they're good, and yours suck.
Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying.
So
how are you going to be successful anywhere else but... If you can't do it in Halifax, how are you going to be successful anywhere else?
I've been doing comedy in Halifax for 10 years.
Jerry, here's my problem, Jerry. Is like I just don't understand. Like, why, if all these other comics are successful, why aren't you getting those guys to come on your charity show?
Right.
I do.
Why don't you work with them?
So then why is there a problem when you're not getting enough people at your shows?
Yeah, there's something up here.
There's
something
wrong. Something you're not telling us.
Something being left out.
You get the. Have you ever had this happen? You try to get people to come to your show, right? And they're like, "No."
Well, nobody
it's
comes
like,
to
well, I'll see if I can come out. They
yeah.
don't come out. No,
that's
no.
a Jerry. That's what we get all the
yeah.
time.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, here's the thing. They don't come to the show, and then the next time they see you, or the day after the show, they have the nerve to come to you and say, "How'd you do?" Or "How was the show?"
Oh, I gotta be honest. I'd fucking hate that.
Yeah, I wouldn't talk to those people.
All right, so Ian. Ian?
Is Ian there?
Is Ian alive?
Ian, you there? Ian?
I think Ian, like...
Ian keeps dropping out because he's calling on a phone and shit.
So you... Jerry,
am I muted?
Oh, you're good, you're good.
Okay, Ian, did you hear what's
going
on with
first of all, Nick,
shows?
Fix the buzzing.
Nah, you can't. This thing's fucked, man. I'm working on it.
All right. Well, you should know that I run the hottest show in Chicago from California, and it's packed, and people are sitting in the stairs every week. And the whole purpose of it is that every week we steal money from charities. There's right, crippled so- kids, there's autistic kids, we're making a killing. They can barely defend themselves.
I like this. See, Jerry, maybe this is what you do.
Take notes, Jerry.
Take notes.
Yes.
Now, can you help him out, Ian, in any way?
Well, the first thing is to have a funny show. You need to bring in a band promoter because they know real people. Comedians don't know real people. They know lonely people that don't leave the house. Ooh. So go find someone that does not comedy and get them to bring their friends out. Other than that, you just got to paper and flyer the fuck out of colleges and the local community areas.
Have you tried doing a show on a college campus, Jerry?
Have you tried handing out cocaine or Molly? They're very popular. You could turn your show into a rave.
Yeah. Cocaine, you say?
Yes. That's ticket. Rather than the heroin you snort before you tell a story.
Yeah, the only white stuff I want inside of me is my own semen. That's it.
You're like George R.R. Martin. Why do you want your semen inside of you? Yeah, are you, like, recycling?
You want to never get laid? You want to never jerk off?
What are you, against recycling? Do you want our planet to die out?
I think Jerry's saying he wants to swallow his own semen.
Well, then it would have to leave him and then come out, you dumb fuck.
I would rather have pussy juice in my mouth than my own semen.
Jerry,
whatever. It's your own, so it doesn't matter.
If I get a swig of pussy juice and my semen, I'm punching a bitch in the face.
Jerry's a big fan of the snowball.
Man, I think this is...
Don't give me... Oh, fuck. The last time I heard that was from Clerks.
Oh, boy.
Are you trying voices? Oh, boy.
Jerry, like...
This is unbelievable.
Jerry.
All in favor?
Nobody comes to my comedy shows. I just want to save the world with funny. But nobody cares about the kids. People have cancer because I'm so bad at comedy. Kids are dying because I can't promote. Boom. I have to write handwritten letters to the parents of all the dead children because I don't have 10 friends. Boom.
Jerry, come on. You know what you need to do, Jerry? You know
I have I have 10 friends, but they're all Habs fans. So.
Yeah, that's why kids are dying.
Oh my God.
Get on OKCupid. How about people meet... There's this thing called the internet.
Wait,
it's full
they still
of
have OKCupid? I thought they got rid of that a while ago.
It's a joke. It's a joke.
Jesus Christ,
man,
it's like talking
that?
To an unfunny signpost.
What's that show? What's that website?
Bad I'm talking Slavo? Seriously here. I'm not trying to be funny all the
Jerry.
Time. Shut up.
You should be.
Not trying to be funny ever.
Jerry, I'm trying to help you. Don't tell me to
better,
shut up.
We'd get a better interview out of a singing bass.
Jesus Christ. Look, Jerry, the thing is like... It seems like the only place you actually advertise your shows is Facebook to, like, your, like, 100 friends.
He's got 1,000, so that's better than me. That's a lot better
than any of
us. That's about 3 times as many as I got.
So I'm just curious, though, like, why are you just doing it on Facebook? Or are you just doing it on Facebook?
No, I'm going out with shows I used to produce that I produced. I put the signs up all over the place. Only problem is... As I said, like, barely anyone shows up because the place where the bar is, it's so far from downtown Halifax.
Oh, shit. So that's the thing,
so then advertise around where the club's going to be.
That's where I'm doing. I'm doing that. I'm doing everything.
Jerry, are you...
People just don't show up. So I said, I'm done with producing shows. I'm just doing regular shows. And people are going to be like, hey, when's your next show? I just tell them, check the fucking website.
See,
I give
Jerry,
people my
Jerry, no one's
going
to ask you because they don't come anyway. No one's going to go... Jerry's got this fantasy, clearly, of, hey, I haven't seen that you had a show in a while. What's going on?
No, Jerry, what?
It's not
going to
happen.
Jerry, okay, first off, Nick, you don't get to talk shit with that fucking faggot silver band around your wrist. Because you start making hand motions,
like
you
this.
Can't do
I
it.
I like this silver
You can't,
band.
Whatever.
It's a nice little.
Yeah, okay.
Damn
anyway,
it, I, yeah.
So, yeah, I know. Right, you had right. to add some bling to my jig.
It was given to me as a gift, so fuck you.
Whatever, so pawn it. Anyway, Jerry, man,
whoa,
didn't you used to do radio?
Back in high school, yeah.
Jerry, man, you gotta get yourself. Jerry, you gotta get promotion. Yeah. Listen, when I listen to the fucking radio, comedians come on and say, "Hey, I'm gonna be at fucking Bob's House of Jokes
That's right.
Well, but Jerry, you want to get your show going, man? You got to do radio.
Just seems like
and
you're
not this shit,
enough.
Not this shitty show. I'm talking
right.
real
Jerry,
radio.
Were you,
right.
were you...
What?
Yeah.
What the fuck just happened?
Ian's fucking shit connection happened. I think Ian's probably stealing a sat like an internet signal from like the Wi-Fi at the back of a strip club.
It says guest,
and it's always going out because some bitch is putting like her fucking CUDA right in front of the modem.
Yeah, yeah.
That's probably what's happening.
Ian, are you there?
Jerry, you got to do some radio, man.
It just seems like that you're not getting out there enough.
Yeah. Jerry, like, it cannot be hard to get on fucking Halifax Radio.
Like, what is Ian doing differently that you're
there
not?
There has got to be, like, Jerry.
Ian doesn't go on the radio, you know?
You know, he was on Man Cow.
True, but, like, not
whatever, okay,
not
but
regularly.
You get what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But Ian's not producing shows.
Wait, but he just said he was. He's producing
but,
one in Chicago.
Chicago's different. There's about 5 million people versus a couple hundred thousand in Halifax.
Okay, so, but it doesn't really matter how many people are there. You can just get out there more.
Jerry, like, why aren't you getting on, like college radio stations? Like, how close are you to Dalhousie? Can't you get on Dalhousie's radio station? Or fucking...
I can, but I'm afraid that the people in the dental school are going to rape me.
Okay.
Oh, you see, Nick doesn't get that joke because he doesn't read.
Okay,
so.
You didn't hear about
that? I know what he's talking about with the fucking
on, that's
that fucking Facebook page.
Yeah.
I'll give that one to you. I was all right with that one. It kind of made me chuckle, but I'm just saying.
Oh, you weren't expecting it.
Right, I wasn't expecting
it was like,
a joke from him.
It was like a fucking, it was like an overhand punch. It was coming out of nowhere.
Right.
So
it's just Jerry.
Jerry, like I think you just, maybe you just suck at promoting.
Right. That's
versus
what, that's
actually,
what I'm trying
to say. It's them. I mean, you know,
it's never. If you produce something funny, they'll come. It just happens that way.
Yeah. So maybe you gotta be like, you know, get on the air with the comics that you're gonna have. Do your how many shows do you do,
Jerry? Oh wait, hold on. Are they regular
if
things?
I'm,
like, is it the same I'm, show every week type shit or what?
No. I usually Wednesday's my night out.
No, not when you're doing shit. I'm talking when you're producing the show.
Jerry, we mean when you're trying to
I'm
produce
not doing,
the show.
I'm not producing shows anymore. I'm done.
We said
done
when you were.
Now. We said when you were, Jerry.
When you were producing a show, was it like the name of a show was Jerry's Funny Night and it happened like every week or every month?
No, the last show I did was, what was it, open mic comedy over where I work at Men's and Molly's.
So you didn't have any regular shows that you were doing on a regular basis?
No.
Maybe that was the problem. Just keep doing it.
Yeah, I was trying in September. Like, we had 3 weeks in September we did it, and then the owner said, yeah, there's no one showing up. We're going to cancel the show. Yeah. So the last show we did, I tried to raise money for a children's hospital. And guess how much money we raised?
$30.
No.
90?
Negative 7.
87.
3.
87 is better than I
can. 3 people got syphilis.
Yeah. Yeah. Jerry got like a couple 4-year-olds some chewable vitamins.
Jerry, maybe you need
Jerry,
to be more
have you
selfie.
Tried doing the Patch Adams thing of just performing for sick kids? Have you tried being Patch Adams and just performing for sick kids?
Yeah. Doesn't sound like a bad idea.
It is a bad. It's a joke.
No. Maybe that's.
I know
actually...
it's a joke. I know it's a joke, but at least, but I know my name's not Roman Polanski, so they probably let me in to do it anyway.
Okay. I'd like to see Jerry do that.
Do you have any references from this century?
Yeah, well, I pretty much do.
Like,
yeah.
Ian is successful because he's greedy as shit with his show that he's producing. So like they figured out a way to do that, but you're like trying to give money away. People don't want to hear about money just being given to people for free. They want to hear about like, hey, I'm gonna make you some money. How about you come to this show?
I've tried, but still.
But you're doing charity shit.
Well, every now and then you got to do a little bit of charity work.
When you're rich, like
yeah, Jerry, you're not.
Is that a Canadian thing?
I guess.
Pretty much,
I would do it.
Why don't you be like a...
You can't be Bill Gates at the dollar store, man.
Be a greedy fuck for a while. Care about yourself more than the fucking cancer patients. Fuck them.
If I can quote Jay-Z, if I can quote him, you can't help...
You can't
poor if you're one of them.
Ah, there you go. Well, Jerry, another successful show that you joined.
Yeah.
Well, it's nice talking to you.
You too.
Okay. Oh, Jerry. Jerry, I feel
bad. I just want to pump. I want to pump my website. It's Mr. M R Jerry G E R R Y, Farr F A R R dot C A.
Yeah.
Jerry. All three out
Jerry,
there. Go
just,
to that website.
Jerry, just you know what you need to do, Jerry. Just get back on the fucking radio, man. That's what you need to do.
Get yourself out there, man.
Yeah, Jerry, don't give up. Like you just need to get back on the fucking radio, man.
Just tell people you suck dick if they come to your show.
No.
No.
I only like my own dick. If I could suck my own dick, I wouldn't need women.
Okay.
Every guy would say that.
Right.
Come on, Jerry, man. Jerry, just keep your chin up, man. You ain't a bad promoter. Well, I mean, you are, but, you know, you can do better. I mean, Ian gave you some help, man. Maybe a band promoter. I know you say you're done, but
Jerry,
I don't think you should give this up, man.
What have you taken from the advice that Ian gave you?
Well, I know someone who does music.
There you
I
go.
I know some people who can do music.
Jerry.
And to them.
Jerry, wait. I got an idea. Jerry, have you ever heard of Metallic? Was it?
Metallica?
No, Metallica. It's his
Metallica?
Band.
Yeah, it's Metallica and Gallagher.
Yeah, it's this band that plays Metallica songs, and then they do Gallagher's jokes in between. Like, why don't you
and they
do
smash watermelons and shit?
Yeah. So why don't you do a show that's like that? Not you being Gallagher because he's racist, but
like do
yeah,
like do comedy between the sets.
Yeah, between the music, so that way you're gonna get both crowds.
Right.
Like. Didn't Richard Pryor fucking have, like, Marvin Gaye open up for him and shit or something?
A lot of comedians will even just open up for the fucking, for the bands. You could do it that way. Just have, like, four or five open micers or whatever the fuck you're doing and have the band afterwards.
Yeah.
It doesn't sound like a bad idea.
But are you telling me you haven't thought of any of this shit?
No, I've been given that suggestion before.
The only thing is, I kind of
lost hope on the city.
It's not the city.
I've lost a lot of hope on
Jerry,
Halifax.
This is what we're talking about, Jerry. It's not. Halifax does suck dick,
right.
But it's not.
It's
them.
Not that,
it's you,
it's
like
that.
Jerry. Like I guarantee, like Jerry. Have you ever seen Def Comedy Jam before?
Yeah.
Okay.
Who hasn't seen Def Comedy Jam?
All right, so you've seen. You remember how Martin Lawrence was the host, right? And in between the other comics coming out, he'd tell some jokes, and then he'd bring them on stage.
I know how to do that.
So why don't you do that, but, like, do bands and do other comics? Like, give these white people that are out there something to want to see.
Hold on,
you know white people love shit music. Come on now.
Jerry, though, are you saying nobody hosts the show?
That's what... Wait, say that again?
Are you telling us that nobody hosts the show? Like... Nobody brings up the comics? None of that?
No, I can do that. No, I know I can bring out the I can bring out the comedians here.
Can you pair with any charities and make it a charity event?
Yeah!
Instead of just a donation?
Yeah, fuck Jerry.
Do something.
Yeah, Jerry, why don't you go, hey, to these charities? Cause and the thing is, Jerry, these charities, man, they got that promotion shit going on. Those motherfuckers will get you on the goddamn radio. Don't give up on this shit, man.
Yeah.
Jerry, you're supposed to be big like Live Nation.
Like, what the fuck are you doing giving up?
You could be charity's black guy.
Exactly!
The only reason you give up on Halifax is because you're moving out of Halifax. You leave. I gave up on my city because I left. I'm not doing anything there. That place sucks. Just leave.
Jesus, Jerry, why don't you try and do the comedy in the gay bar that you work in?
Yeah.
You do it
I tried that twice.
Okay, but did you get, like, an AIDS charity in there or something? Like, give them something they fucking need the money, will want to be a part of. Like, if you're going in there and you're... Say Jerry, let's be hypothetical.
Wait a minute. I think we might be missing the fact that Jerry has a superpower, which is that he can disperse people. We should be sending you into riots in Ferguson, and everybody will clear out and go home because they don't want to be part of what you're doing.
Jerry, we're sending you on a totally expense-paid trip to Ferguson.
And we're going to get you spandex and everything.
Maybe that's where Jerry should be doing the comedy show.
Belongs.
In Ferguson.
Yeah.
Like, hey, if you
where
don't
the
hell is get...
Ferguson?
Oh, my God.
Jerry, have you considered fighting a cop?
Holy
Done.
Shit.
You fought a cop?
Yeah.
Where what happened.
Okay, see, Jerry, these are the things stories that you need to talk about in your show. Don't just do the Habs fans. They were all watching the game. Jerry, these are the things that people want to, like...
Yeah, everybody's heard, if I check my own dick.
Dude, Jerry is literally... This maybe is a problem with Jerry, though. He is trying to tell jokes.
Yeah.
But he's...
He's got some stories.
Like, Jerry, like, these things, like you got stories, right? But it's like trying to give a kid fucking cough syrup. Like, we got to fucking force it at you, and we're spilling it. You're like, nope. Nope. Just, Jerry, just open your mouth.
Tell us how you fought a cop. Yeah. What happened?
Oh, frig. I don't even remember half of it right now. I'm half in the fucking bag right now.
Maybe you should quit drinking.
No, actually. Hold on.
All right.
Okay, so I was working late one night, right? And when I got home, my roommate at the time had some friends over. I didn't really know about that. So when I got into the apartment, went to my room, three of his friends came out of my room.
Ooh.
All guys. But then I looked there, and on my bed was one girl pulling up her pants.
Nice. Gangbang.
Choo-choo okay. Train.
Yeah.
Did you clean
so
up those sloppy
seconds? Like,
dude,
you gotta... So I'm like, dude, you gotta go. And I mean, you gotta go. He refused to leave, so I had to call the cops.
Okay.
Right? So... With Halifax police, they fucking suck.
Right.
Because you heard
do.
About the whole Ray Parsons thing, right?
Okay.
Oh, my fucking God.
Starting
what
up
is this ungodly thing?
You what?
Are you mowing your lawn?
What the fuck was that?
Go on, Jerry. So these guys got to leave. What happens now?
So I was calling the cops. I'm like, this guy won't leave my apartment. He doesn't pay rent,
and
I tell him, you better get the cops here within the next 5 minutes, or else I'm going to take them out myself, and the dispatcher's like, oh, we can't guarantee a time they can come. And I said, well, you better guarantee them within the next 5 minutes before I do fucking something.
Okay, all right. So what
they
happened?
Said, what if we Domino's pizza?
So
we
they
can't
get
do
them,
it.
So the guy gets there in 3 minutes. I bring him up to my apartment, and I get up there. I get him up there. I'm like, this is the guy. Get him out.
Are you sure
and
you got him up there?
Yeah. The cop comes up there.
Where's this girl without her pants on? That's what I want to know.
Yeah, and why weren't you fucking her, too?
I told you I was at work.
But her pants were still down when you got there.
Yeah, I was at work, and I want to stay STD-free. So,
let's get back
to the story. So I bring the cop into my apartment, and I'm like, okay, this is the guy I want out of my apartment. So... I show him my ID and a copy of my lease, right? And this guy has the nerve to tell me that guy technically lives there, because I told him he's not on my lease. He has not paid rent in 2 months here, and he let a bunch of people have sex or do God knows what on my fucking bed. And I tell him, if you don't get him out right now, I'm going to file a complaint against you. And he's coming up to me saying, do not threaten me. And he grabs me by my shirt, right?
Oh, shit.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. And I said, I threatened your job, not you. He said, do not threaten me. So I go to push him off and call self-defense on that. He tries to have me arrested. He goes to have me arrested, right? So he finally gets the guy out, and I'm still in cuffs. But luckily there was another cop there. And then another couple cops come in, and they said, well, he grabbed you first, so...
Hold on, Jerry, was that the fight?
Well, I was about to throw a punch, but one of the cops grabbed my arm and put my hands behind my back, and I said, I didn't technically hit him. It's not assault.
Jerry's like, I didn't shoot him. The gun did. Yeah. I didn't kill him. The bullet did.
We need some bullets to kill some Halifax police.
I can't tell you how many times black people have talked about how litigious the police are about following the law. No, he didn't technically punch him. Let's let him go. We love black people.
People don't kill people. Guns do.
Well, it's just that It's just that the cop had some complaints against him, too.
Oh,
so,
shit.
Yeah. Okay, so I said, you let this issue go, and, you know, you let this issue go, I'll let my issue go. So we went our separate ways.
Damn,
and then you just went upstairs and slept in the wet spot? Yeah.
So what happened to the girl, though? Is she still there with her pants off?
Yeah.
No, she left the night before I kicked the guy out.
Wait. I thought this was the same night. Yeah, I thought this was all the same night.
No, the same night, the 7 minute the other people left, my roommate at the time was, like, drunk out of his mind, lying on his bed. So the next day, I'm just like, dude, you gotta go. That's not cool. I mean, that's why I don't trust roommates anymore.
I gotta be honest, Jerry.
Jerry, you should have told the story the way we thought it was.
Yeah.
It
yeah.
I mean, the story wasn't bad,
so
but it would have been good.
You didn't call the police
if,
on the three guys at the train.
No.
Jerry, I gotta be honest. One of your better stories that's been on here. You got to the point, not bad, yep. You know?
Let me guess, when I came on a stop sign, right?
Well, no, that was the worst one you ever told. But this wasn't bad. It's just we wanted to hear it the way we thought it was. It, you know, it should have all happened on the same night.
Yeah, we thought it was all on the same night.
Yeah, because the way you told it.
Yeah. And, like, the girl's up there with her fucking cuda out.
Yeah.
And you're like, yo, everyone get the fuck out of my house. And the cops are like, nah, these niggas can stay here and fuck this bitch.
Yeah.
Fuck you. And you're like, nah.
And the cops got in on it and shit like that.
Yeah. The cops had to zip their pants back up just to take you down.
Yeah, right. And Jerry's sitting there is like with his lease in his hand, and the cop's like, yeah, this is some good pussy. And Jerry's just watching.
Yeah.
Being like, if you don't get these guys and that bitch out of my house, I'm gonna fucking sue you. And the cop's like, yeah, I'm gonna take this pussy. Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, I'm gonna Rodney King this pussy. Yeah.
Well, Jerry, this might be where you want to get out.
Yeah,
you know,
Jerry, you probably
get out after a
top.
Good story. Yeah, go on top.
Yeah,
I don't know. I think Jerry wants to tell us about his tattoos and his piercings.
Jerry, it's a good time for you to go up.
Yeah, I am half in the fucking bag. I'm gonna go to sleep.
It sounds like more than half, but
yeah.
Yeah. Well, good appearance, and hopefully you get back on the horse of producing things, because you either. You know, get some shows going or leave that city. That's your options right now.
I'm thinking of leaving Halifax.
Yeah, you should. Come to Toronto. We'll do shit together.
You could also eat a bullet. That's also an option.
Right. You should. You really
never
should.
Rule out suicide.
Right. You know, we all haven't. So you shouldn't either. All right, Jerry. Nice talking to you.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, go Later. go sleep.
Yeah.
Okay. Bye-bye. Fucking.
Anyway, hey, what's up?
Jerry just drives me fucking mental.
Who the fuck is Kenzie Sandoval?
I get random fucking
Who's
people.
Ariel Mosley? Who's Jammy Jones?
I get random people trying to add me on Skype all the time because of this fucking show.
Man, I think Jerry... I'm not even gonna lie. I think Jerry has, like, a hint of Asperger's in him. Just, like, a hint.
Like a dash?
Just a dash. There's a bit of a stutter with him. Just a tiny bit.
And he just kind of doesn't know little social cues and things like that.
Yeah.
Anyway,
I think Jerry has stories, but I'm like, it's like, Jerry, like, oh, we're not doing this anymore?
No, we are.
Oh, it's like, Jerry, come on, you got to know, there are funny parts that you're missing.
Right. Like, and that whole...
I bet Jerry could actually be successful if you could cut all the fat off.
His breath smells like pennies.
Yeah, Jerry just like the one-liners. He wants to be like the next one-liner king.
That's what I'm talking about. You know? Jerry, you need to just tell stories, but cut the fat off.
Right. Look,
you have stories.
Somehow he's getting himself in all these stories. Why not? Yeah, figure out how to make them, you know, concise.
I think Jerry doesn't think they're good stories. Because in his mind, in his head, he goes
treats jokes like it's a fucking Game of Thrones novel.
Yeah.
It's like, no, but yeah.
Like, this has to have as many details as possible and last.
Like, Jerry, we don't need to know the name of all the fucking place.
Right. We don't need to hear that you got him up there.
And then he leaves out major details.
Right. That we got to force out of him, like you said, trying to get fucking cops here for the kid. We're trying to get him to, like, what happened, Jerry? What fucking happened?
It's like, Jerry is literally Bobo. With all the regular cells, but just one cell that is fucked.
Yeah.
One tiny one in there.
Yeah. He's just missing a few brain cells or something.
Yeah, Jerry's like, I bet you Jerry could actually be a good comic. I think he could be a good comic.
If he gets that crayon
if he would just
out of his brain.
Exactly, yeah. Like Homer.
There's a crayon
if he
in
would
there.
Just tell the stories and cut the fat off.
Right.
I think he's the afterbirth of, like, Mr. Rogers fucking one of his puppets. Yeah. Like, he's almost people.
And he even looks like a puppet, doesn't he? He's got a bit of a puppet look to him. Like, he should have his mouth that's kind of just dangling there.
Why don't we get Lane in here? What's going on?
You think Lane can get on here?
I don't know.
You know, I kind of want to talk about Brian Stern a little bit.
Oh, fuck. Okay.
You know, we had a bit
I really don't want to talk about
it was a bit of an event last episode, and
Brian Stern was unfriended.
Yes.
Good.
Wait, was he?
Well, he's not friends with you anymore.
Oh, shit, he unfriended me.
Good.
Ooh.
Good.
Brian Stern unfriended me because of our last episode.
Good.
Ian?
Good.
He's liked one of my pictures. As far as I know, we're still friends.
You talked to him?
And as far as I know, he's still handicapped. I don't talk to people anyway.
Okay. Now, I'm trying to find it, but it was like a week ago. He had to post something right after he fucking hung up on this show. Let's talk about the other one first. He commented on our last episode. He goes, first off, I don't have a career, nor do I claim to. Second off, second of all, I didn't articulate my point as well as I would have liked to.
That's your fucking fault.
Right. What he's saying is, hey, I fucked up on the last episode, and can you take my name off that name of the episode?
Third and finally, because he has to make this like it's like his list.
Third and finally, I would appreciate people who I don't even know keeping my name out of their mouths and their opinions of me to themselves, because as Jay Cutler once said...
Oh, hey, way to throw in that Bears reference.
Yeah.
See, this is what I'm saying. Brian Stern is the Jerry Favre of the Midwest.
He
had to throw in that local sports reference. Get the hometown on your side. Jay Cutler, the seven-year, $100 million quarterback that they're going to cut now. Yeah, let's bring him up, you fucking idiot. Is Lane here?
No, I don't think Lane's in here. I don't think anybody's in here anymore. Ian, are you there?
I'm trying to be. I'm walking. I'm wondering if it is in these buildings and if I can go find a field to lay down, dig a hole, and die in. Maybe I'll get reception.
Might be nice.
Jeez, you don't want to die. I mean, look, Brian Stern was holding you back. I mean, I don't think you should die now.
I just want to talk about it. He just said
Brian Stern was the reason why your fucking Supreme Justice didn't get played. That's the reason.
He started chirping, and right after the show, when
he
posted something like,
"Of course he did."
Oh, I just got told that I fucking suck or some other shit, and then everybody. Oh, that's where it was.
What?
Dude, I actually copied and pasted it because
good!
I knew it was going to delete it. Oh, shit, I'm a genius.
Yeah, good.
Here it is.
Brian Stern's Facebook post.
All right. He goes, so I'm a hack and only get stage time because I'm
guys,
crippled.
Did my joke go through before I cut out again?
Which was what, about laying in a hole
I
and
said
dying?
He does write a lot of letters, and why wouldn't he? His legs are half a desk.
All right.
So he writes, so I'm a hack and only get stage time because I'm crippled, just like my sex life.
That's true.
I'll take what I can get. Haters gonna hate. That was immediately after you
Carolyn
destroyed.
Carolyn Ramos City Klein, that's
right.
Not true.
Now all his.
Oh, fuck you!
Yeah, that's not true, Brian.
Oh, my God. I hope someone. You know what? Someone should fucking attach her mouth to a fucking trailer hitch and rip it out.
Like,
fuck
do
her.
These people really have to fucking. Like a
hence,
him.
Haters gonna hate. Let me read this. Johnny P. Pekulis. You're not a hack. You're just not funny. I like that guy. That guy's good.
Well, no, but then watch what he says after that.
Matt, when you're right, you're... Oh, that's very funny. Nah, you're funny. We all need to work. We need to find our voice. How about paragraphs?
Yeah.
I think you do make...
You know, I've been having a real problem with this lately, with people wanting to be a fucking goddamn inspiration to people. Calm it down. Your life story doesn't matter.
Like, yeah,
this
like
stop
guy,
trying to turn everything into a fucking Disney movie.
This guy should have kept it. Johnny should have kept it at you're not a hack. You're just not funny. Because that's like a comedian thing to say to a friend, and then not go on about how you know you need to be a little more comfortable on stage with the cripple jokes and you know he had to like come back with something positive because he didn't want to feel like a
no,
piece
you go
of
down,
shit.
Keep going down. I'm reading this.
All right.
Because he has a soul?
Well, no, he shouldn't have a soul. That's what I'm saying.
Well, I think if Brian Stern doesn't want to be part of the show, we should leave it at this and never bring him up again.
Well, of course. I just had to bring up the post because it's kind of an ongoing
thing. Whoa, who the fuck's Mike Stricker? Here we go. All
right, so what did you say?
Yeah. That's what I was told by someone I never met when I was doing a buddy's podcast with others. That's what's so funny about it to me. Really? It was funny?
Right.
Really?
Right. See? And that's I just wanted to bring that up. He just goes... You know,
oh, he was just angry because he doesn't get the parking I do. Get killed. Fucking Mike Stricker. I hope you fucking eat thumbtacks and die. Fuck you too.
So there you go. I just wanted to bring up a little bit.
You make it so hard for me to have a career.
Look, now this guy's like, this is what I'm talking about. Why does everyone have to be profound? This is what Jerry's trying to do. Jerry's trying to do that shit, and I'm trying to help this motherfucker. I'm trying to stop him.
Right.
Stop trying to be profound and I'm trying to get the applause break. I bet that's what Mike Stricker does too, you fucking bitch. But I bet that's what he does.
Ian, we never really heard.
I am tired of this fucking Care Bear generation that believes in the power of friendship and positive thinking.
That's what I'm
Take down your spirit board and eat a bullet, you fucking sissies.
That's what I'm See, this is why Ian is my nigga right here, because he gets what I'm fucking saying.
Ian, can we have like an official statement on the Brian Stern event from you?
Yeah, we're gonna need a CIA type statement.
Yeah.
We're gonna need the fucking 9/11 commission report.
I should have known that it was a bad idea to have him on.
It was a great idea. Let's be
but
honest.
I was drunk. And I feel bad about having him on because I feel like I set him up because he didn't have the skills to defend himself.
Is that a compliment to me? In a way?
It is. He basically...
It is, but it's like I brought a retarded kid for you to pound on. And then I was mad when you pounded on a retarded kid.
Eh, whatever. It was fun. Sometimes, you know, you gotta do things like that to make yourself feel good. Like, you know, I was fucking with the,
It's like if you went to a dog fight with Michael Vick and then dropped a chicken in the ring. You can't be mad when he eats the chicken.
Good. Good, and fuck him. I hope, you know what, he does
Especially
only get...
that chicken in a wheelchair.
Jesus, like, Jerry's funnier than him, and Jerry's a retard, and...
Jerry's not funnier than him.
Yeah,
they're the same level of funny to me.
Here's what I love about Brian.
Yeah, but Brian Stern
fucking,
gets...
Like, he's an evil, bitter person.
Who is?
Brian.
Yeah, like Brian, but Brian only gets played because he's a cripple. Because it's more interesting to see the guy in the chair go up there and tell the jokes than anybody else. Any white guy... That is not crippled is not going to get on before Brian Stern.
Okay,
that's a fact.
Especially
he knows it. That's just like in a comedy show. You know, women are going to get like they have women's nights because there's not a lot of women comics. There's not a lot of crippled comics, so you're going to get on stage even if you're shittier than the next guy. All things being equal, the cripple guy is going to get on the stage. Everyone knows that.
We should start a cripple night, comedy night.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so even now
it's like Louis Twitchell Santani. Not funny.
Yeah.
Got to use what you got.
Right.
You know, you're a hack. What do you want from me?
Ian feels bad about it, but he knows that it was funny.
He shouldn't feel bad about it. Ian should not feel bad about it. Because you know what, Ian? You don't need that shit in your life, man. You don't want that shit. You don't want them clingers on, man. You don't want no barnacles, man. You don't need barnacles. That's what Brian Stern is. He's a barnacle. He's a fucking wheelie barnacle.
Well, there you go. I just wanted to talk about it to round, like, get some closure on that shit.
Ian is fucking, like, Ian's going to be big time. Ian's trying to make it big time. He doesn't need barnacles, man. He don't need leeches.
He'll do something with it, I think.
I'm really amazed you guys haven't hung up on me yet. This is so fucking annoying.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, whatever.
But, you know, we're stretching.
Instead of the usual $10, I should only get $8.50 for the show.
Well, yeah, we'll give you a little bit less.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it was a shit show anyway.
You go up.
We did have
up.
Jerry Farr on it, so.
Well, whatever. I enjoy talking about football. Go up! Fuck's sakes. Go to the top.
It's at the top.
Okay, Cincinnati, Pittsburgh. That doesn't really mean shit.
All right. Well, you know, that was a good show.
Are we done now?
We talked to Jerry. We made fun of him a little bit. We concluded the Brian Stern saga. And now,
it's all good. It's all for the show.
You know, we'll end it all off with some sort of shit. And thanks to Ian for coming on, even though you kind of, you know, your connection was shit. But everything's good. We'll talk to everybody next week. Ooh.